Okay, if you're using Google Sheets and at the bottom you have several different sheets that you're working with, you may find that you want to create a list of them. Say if you had a table of contents, which is what I'm doing here, you could automatically list out the names of the sheets, and you probably want these names to change if you update the names of the sheets. That's what we're going to go over here, and I have several different ways to do it here depending on what you want to do. So let's go into cell B3 and look, and this is a custom function, and we're going to create this as we go along. So we called it sheet name, and it's referencing this cell. We'll talk about why it's doing that in a minute. But first we're going to talk about how to create a custom function. It's only a couple steps. So what you want to do is you want to go to Tools and use the Script Editor. And when you left click on Script Editor, it's going to launch a new tab. And just copy these from my website. It's linked from this card in the upper right hand corner. Or you can just go to the web address that I'll list below in the video description. Don't try to type them out yourself. And when you put them in here, you need to save this. I just called it code.js. Doesn't really matter what you call it. But I'll click save. Just briefly, we have sheet name that we created. We're going to go over that first. That's going to just return the name of the sheet that the function is on. This function is going to return the names of all the sheets. And this function is going to return the name of a particular sheet that you specify. That's three of them. You'll notice there's four of them here because this last one is not a custom function. But the first one, so sheet name. We just created this function. Let's type it in. It doesn't pre-populate with the little helpers that tell you the different functions because this one is not made by Google Sheets, so it doesn't know what you're doing. We just do sheet name and we pass it nothing inside the parentheses, but you need the parentheses regardless, and hit enter. Takes a while to think about it, but then it returns the sheet name, table of contents. If you do sheet names, we don't need the C15 in here, we'll add that in a bit, and press enter, it thinks about it a little bit, and it returns the names of the worksheets, but it returns all of them. So if I had 15, it would spit out a list of 15. And then the last one that we built is called sheet number, and you pass this the number of the sheet that you want it to return. So say we wanted sheet number 4, which is detail 2 with a space in it. That space is there on purpose. We'll show you in a minute. That's probably 1, 2, 3. That's the 4th sheet. And there we go. It returned detail 2. So the issue with these and why I'm going to offer a 4th alternative is that if you change the name of one of the sheets, these don't automatically update. So we'll come down here and we're going to call summary. We're going to call it lead sheet instead. We'll come back and this one's wrong. It still says summary. Now this one isn't wrong because I didn't change the name of table of contents, but if I did, it would not have updated. So keep that in mind as you make these custom functions. Now there is a workaround to this. What you can do is in the name of the function, you can pass it a range, but don't overlap it with the name of the sheet. We'll do A15 and we'll make it big. We'll say over to G55. And if you give it this range, what that's going to do, first of all, since I changed it, you can see that it updated. But if I didn't change that, that would not have updated. Going to go change the name of lead sheet back to summary. We'll see that this didn't update, but now that this is referencing this range, if I use this sheet for anything else in that range, let's say I just put a 5 in, it will update the function. So that's a decent workaround for having this function update. It's not going to work all the time though. It's not perfect because if you don't put anything in this range, it won't update. And if you are using this range and you're using it a lot, it's going to slow you down from updating all the time. And the last function that we have, this is also in the description, is kind of a convoluted list of built-in functions that you just copy and paste in here. And these will update automatically. It'll take a bit. They might not update in real time, but they will update as you use the sheet. And I'll show you how this works. So it's a long function and the if today equals today, it's just a trick in here to get it to update. And then it's a regular expression where it extracts the name of the worksheet. but what you have to fill in is the name of the worksheet here. But once you fill it in, it will update. So if I call this one Detail 1 and I hit enter, it will return Detail 1. But if I go to it and I call it Detail Space 1 and I come back, it updated automatically. You'll have to build it first. So you'll have to go in and reference this one to the table of contents. You'll have to reference the next one, the summary. So if you have lots of sheets, it'll take you a while to build it, but it will be dynamic and you build it once and it'll work. In between these four, you should be able to find one that works for what you're doing in your sheet. And once you're done with this, if you want to share your sheet, but you want to do it in a secure way, we're going to talk in this next video about how to do that. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe if you like the video. Thanks.